I'm Jeremy Porter. I'm a professor of sociology, and I am the director of the Quantitative Methods in the Social Sciences program. There's a huge void, I think, in both academia and in the real world in terms of the gulf between our theoretical understanding of social issues and our ability to quantitatively understand those issues with the vast amounts of data that people are collecting. So the program is really geared towards people that have that theoretical background in the social sciences, but they also want to gain quantitative capabilities to take data, ask meaningful research questions, and then use that data to answer those research questions. Students vary in terms of stages of their academic career. So we have brand new undergraduate students that are looking to move on to PhD programs. We have professionals that are coming back to gain skills in quantitative methods. And we have people that already have PhDs that want to come back because they don't have the training that they believe they need in quantitative methods. The foundational courses in the program require students to work through the basics of quantitative methods and get a good, strong understanding of statistical applications. After the foundational courses, students can move beyond that to take more advanced quantitative methods courses. They can take more substantive courses in the social sciences if they're interested in developing a theoretical framework to apply those methods. We offer a lot of courses in statistical programming. And we're really interested in sort of building student skills in cutting-edge software programs and programming languages that employers are looking for. The program has four different concentrations. There's a generic methods program, which entails 10 courses of just methodological training. Students can take any courses they want after our foundational classes. There's a analytics for learning track that students can take if they're interested in the use of data. To understand how students learn or to how to effectively communicate information to students within the field of education. We have a social inequalities track, an economic inequalities track at the local, regional, and national level, which combines the Urban Research Center and the Stone Center for Economic Inequalities. We have a demography track, which is also associated with the CUNY Institute for Demographic Research. All four tracks are fairly flexible in terms of how students move through the tracks, but we do have a good group of professors in each track. We teach a lot of our courses with cutting-edge statistical programming tools like R and Python. Students also learn how to work with foundational quantitative methods and then build from that. So they'll learn how to analyze relationships between variables, but then they'll also understand how to manage that data and what that data looks like when it's restructured. Our teaching philosophy is really guided by application. So it's really a hands-on program. All of our classes have some type of a lab component to them. Part of our program is a capstone, a thesis course, where students will take everything that they've learned in the curriculum and they'll end up applying that to some type of a real-world research project at the end of the program. But there's also opportunities to work with our professors. The quantitative methods in the social sciences program is unique because of the interdisciplinary nature of the program. We have a sociology department, the economics department, the educational psychology department, the demography program, and other programs at the Graduate Center. All of these programs, again, are housed by world-renowned faculty who implement quantitative methods in their everyday research. All the classes are taught by full-time faculty members. The students have the opportunity to work alongside with PhD students in their training, and they gain a rigor of understanding and exposure to methods and techniques that they wouldn't be able to gain access to in the master's only program. Related to that, there's the CUNY Institute for Demographic Research, the Stone Center for Economic Inequality, the Urban Research Center, and other institutes and centers on campus. All of them are always happy to have students that have strong quantitative capabilities and can contribute to their research. No matter what your area professionally, there's data that's being collected there, whether you work for a government agency or you work for a nonprofit or you work for an academic institution or you go into private industry, all of them are collecting data. All of them have questions that they're asking about this data, and all of them need people that can form strong research questions, that can design research programs around those questions, and then can use data to answer questions. So there's not really one area that students can go into. Really all professional opportunities need people that understand quantitative methods.